Alrighty, so we have Pannie Kianzad versus Alexis Davis. So Pannie, she is 1 inch taller, but Alexis Davis does have a 2 inch reach advantage. Alexis Davis is getting up there in age, you know, she's nearly 37 now, so never one to rely on her speed, but you know, as she does get older, she doesn't have the best striking defense. Is she gonna be able to take the shots that she's been able to take throughout her whole career? You know, questions, questions. But yeah, Pannie has been on a bit of a hot streak at the moment. 3-fight win streak in the UFC, which is always good. And yeah, let's get into the striking. So for Pannie, she has nice boxing. She has nice boxing combinations. Definitely has the hand speed advantage here. Nice step in jab. Will double up, triple up on the jab. Followed up with a two. You know, she has nice straight punches. For Davis, her stand-up's a little bit more basic. She's mostly one and done for the most part. She has a nice counter two. That's what she's looking for mostly, and then that low calf kick, which I think is a good tool of hers, and it could become a problem for Pannie because, you know, she is coming from that boxing foundation, so she is quite heavy on the lead leg, but Pannie does have, you know, quite nice movement, and she moves around the octagon quite well, so it is hard to pin her down and, you know, land those leg kicks, but every time she, you know, she comes in, closes distance, I think she could smash her with that leg kick. And you know, for Kianzad, she can be a little predictable with her striking entries. She generally comes in on a straight line. Whenever she pops the double jab, she's looking to close distance for the two, and she has a bad tendency of overextending on her two in close range, or just getting too predictable with the straight right, because yeah, she will overextend on it in close range, and then opponents start looking for the double leg, and you see her getting caught by the double leg quite frequently in her fights. I think Sarge caught her with it a few times. I think Avalar caught her with it, so it's obviously something her opponents are looking for. And for Davis, that's probably where she wants to get it, onto the mat. She doesn't proactively wrestle that much, but she's very good at catching a kick and trying to ground the opponent, and then once she gets you onto the mat, she looks to pass to side control, looks to take the back with one hook in once, you know, the opponent does turn. But yeah, top control, it's pretty nice. And like, when you get Kianzad down, she doesn't show great urgency to get off her back or, you know, get back to her feet when she is taken down. But if you try and take her down in the clinch, like with trips or whatever, she has nice knees to the body, she got nice elbows as well, so, you know, it's not easy to take her down, but once you do get her down, you generally can hold her down for quite a long time. Alright, so how these guys win fights. So for Alexis Davis, she's quite durable, and when she does get on top, she does have good top control. You know, she transitions well, she you know, doesn't get too reckless on top, so she does have good top control. And for Kianzad, she has nice offensive boxing and good volume on the jab especially, and then good cardio as well. Alright, so how these guys lose fights. So for Kianzad, it's the get-ups, we've already talked about that. And for Davis, it's that she's quite hittable on the feet and that she marks up quite easily, so she's got a lot of scar tissue. She is getting up there in age, she's been in a lot of fights, so yeah, scar tissue's kind of adding up for Alexis Davis. Alright, so past the victory for these two. So for Alexis, I think she should go with the low calf kicks, because Pannie's going to be heavy on the lid leg as she is closing distance, so I think she should look to chop her down as she comes close, and, you know, that might make Pannie a little bit more light on her feet, and might stop popping at the jab so often, so that would be a good thing. And just be proactive with takedowns, like, don't wait for her to throw a body kick or a leg kick to catch one of them and then look to take her down, as you did in the Marzo fight. Look to actually seek takedowns instead of just being, you know, reactive to it, because, yeah, like, you know, you're not going to win on the feet, so, in my opinion, so, just, yeah, look for takedowns. Because in the Marzo fight, like, she wasn't looking for takedowns until Marzo threw kicks, and then she looked to catch one of the kicks and then take her down, and she just dominated on the mat, but she didn't really look for takedowns. Like, she just, it was just all reactive, and I wouldn't wait for Kianzad to throw a kick, because she's likely not going to throw any. But yeah, so look to level change, get into the clinch when she's going for the 1-2, when she steps in for the 1-2, and then once you get her down, look for top control, look to keep her on the mat, just keep top position pretty much. And if you're struggling with the takedowns, look to press her against the fence and look for takedowns from there. And for Kianzad, look to take the front foot, but don't be too over aggressive. But just really, you can stick and move with the jab if you really want. Like, Viviani Arujo, she had great success with that. She was lighting Davis up on the feet and just snapping her with the jab every time she came in. But yeah, no kicks, as I said, you know, no point throwing kicks. She's just going to try and catch them and then, you know, take you down. Look for a hard two down the pipe when she does look to leg kick or look to check the leg kicks, up to you. And look to set up your right hand. Don't just throw it naked because she will just like level change under it and look to take you down. And if you do get taken down, look to get back to your feet. Just don't accept bottom position too much, okay? How I see the fight going. So on the feet, I think Pannie just lights her up, honestly. Big speed advantage, big power advantage. You know, Davis has a path to victory with the grappling, I feel, but she really looks for takedowns, and most of the fight, it seems she's just comfortable with her opponents just teeing off on her on the feet, and then, you know, she'll go for takedowns when her opponent kicks and she catches one, but she wasn't really proactively wrestling in the Marzo fight, and I thought that was a real red flag for me, because she had such a clear advantage on the mat. Yeah, so I don't trust the fight IQ of either of these fighters too much, honestly. Also didn't like how Pannie looked off her back against Eubanks. You know, Sarge is a good top player, but she just showed no urgency to get back to her feet, and then Sarge just was very comfortable on top of her. And I think, you know, that's the path to victory for Alexis Davis, is just the top control, just get on top. But I feel like this fight's going to be decided by who comes in with the better game plan and who has the better fight IQ on the night. I think it's quite a close fight. Like, if I had to pick, I'd probably say Pannie. Because I think she keeps on the feet, does enough damage to warrant a decision. And if Alexis Davis comes in with a wrestling-heavy game plan, I think she could look like a solid favorite here. But I just don't trust either of these guys with the fight IQ. But yeah, probably dog or pass in this fight. All right, so I do have Pannie by decision. But I think she should be a very small favorite. You know, I think this fight's basically a pick'em. I think I'd favor Pannie 55 to 50% of the time, so, you know, just edge Alexis Davis out. And I think the line is a little bit wide at the moment, and I think I'd bet Alexis Davis at anything over plus $2.50 plus $1.50 or $2.50. But yeah, I think if she gets a few takedowns, like, it could be a good live betting fight. If she can get a takedown, then yeah, you know, she'd probably be winning the fight because she just needs one around, basically.